Otitis Media. This one has been trying to get answered.
It's because it's one of those kind of simple ones, and yet it bothers, it comes up. But I can tell you that, you don't talk about test questions. You're not allowed to talk about test questions when you walk out. But I do recall a question about this on the exam. And the person had said, my 3-year-old is prone to ear infections. I work at an allergy office that she goes to regularly, and I was looking at her chart to get dates of ear infections for her ENT appointment she had on Monday. Anyway, question is, what is the difference between the 381.01 otitis media acute and the one otitis media allergic? I noticed the documentation was fairly similar, and I can't find the paper now, but two of the three times she was given an antibiotic, yet each time it had one of these two diagnoses. Also, the last visit, the doctor or PA told me that she didn't have an ear infection, that the ear were red, yet the diagnosis was otitis media acute and no antibiotic. Okay, so she's ultimately confused about the details about otitis media and the adjectives that go along with it. So, what is otitis media? There's a link which I kind of copied the information here. Oh, and somebody cleaned this up. I bet that was you, Lauren. There are three kinds of ear infection which are called acute otitis media. And again, acute means sudden onset. Otitis media with effusion, which means that there is pressure built up behind the ear, and otitis externa, which is swimmer's ear, which I know some of you have heard that. That is just meaning that the ear canal is irritated. Now, with all of those, you can have some other things. One of the key words besides acute and chronic, and most of you will know what that is, but you have to pay attention to that. They are different codes. And if I'm writing a test question, you bet I'm going to throw one of those in there because it lets me know, or the it lets me know if you're paying attention to the details. You've got to pay attention to the adjectives. And that's what they're wanting to know on the CPC exam. One word can make a lot of difference. Okay, in acute serous otitis media, the infection of the middle ear is accompanied by a buildup of fluid, usually due to inflammation of the eustachian tube, preventing drainage. Scroll down to the ear real quick, Laureen, that we've got. Okay, so here you've got the ear canal, and you've got the eardrum right there, that little pink circle there. Now, then in the middle ear, that can have pressure. Fluid can build up in there, and all that can have swelling and stuff. The eardrum will bulge ultimately, and then if it's bulging, then they know it's with effusion. If you've ever had a chance to see inside an ear, and I advise you to go on YouTube, and you can see all kinds of pictures. But that's how they would diagnose otitis media with effusion. Now, when they say serous, what they're saying is ultimately, is there any pus? Is there any drainage? Serous fluid, that's what that means. Is there something oozing out of the eardrum, around the eardrum? And so they'll look in the ear. If it is just irritated, the ear canal is just irritated, it's inflamed, it's itchy, think of itis, there's irritation there. That is a lot of times due to an allergic reaction. It doesn't have to be because it's infected. If the eardrum is bulging, then you have effusion. If you have all three of those things, and on top of that, fluid coming out of the ear, that's also when you would need an antibiotic. A lot of times they will not give an antibiotic for just irritation, but they will give it for fluid, the buildup, the bulging eardrum, and they'll give it for, because a lot of times your eardrum will go ahead and perforate, and they don't know what's behind the eardrum. Is it pus? Is it just pressure? What's back there? They can't see it. And it actually becomes it. Your eardrum is actually kind of clear, and if it's white and foggy, they know there's something back there. Okay, so then the buildup of the fluid, let's see, and the fluid, the oh, and the drainage. So acute allergic serous otitis media. That means sudden onset. It was brought on because of an allergic reaction. There's fluid or something coming out of the ear that's made it inflamed. 381.04. Now, your doctor may not write all of that. You may have to go in and see, he'll write acute or chronic because that's just a given, but he may not write allergic. And if he doesn't say allergic, you can't say it's allergic. If he indicates that it's allergic reaction or the patient has allergies or something, then you can probably draw the line and use that 04. If it doesn't say due to an allergic reaction of any kind, you can't use that code. So now 381.10. Completely different scenario. Chronic, that means this has been going on for a long time. Maybe, they've had it either for a long time or they get them repeatedly. Serous, so you have fluid draining, there's stuff coming out of the ear, whether there's pus or fluid or something. An inflammation, simple or unspecified. Now, this is probably one of the more common codes that are used because especially with a child that keeps getting an ear infection, they don't know. Have we just not been able to get it cleared up? We've got fluid, we've got inflammation, and he didn't say whether it was simple or unspecified. So this is kind of a if there's fluid, this is going to be a catch-all one. Now, when you go into 381, did you do your are you able to bring up that page, or is that too much work to
Which one?
bring up the
This
manual? The
is this a
manual,
page?
the 381
For a
in the
supercoder? I
ICD-9.
can do supercoder.
Okay, I'm not sure if it looks the same as the manual, but I bet it does. And okay, you want to just pay attention to those fine-tune words, those adjectives. Is it there you go. Put in 381 and let it give them the details of all of them. That's what's so great about these. You can, if you know kind of where you're at, it'll give you. There's more than just those ones I mentioned. See, you've got acute non-suppurative. That means there's no fluid. I mean, there's nothing coming out of the ear. There's no pus. There's no drainage. Then it's, zero. One, chronic, and there's fluid. Mucoid is just another word for mucus. Other unspecified, nothing coming out of the ear. Now, all of these are going to use another digit, mind you. But see all of your options there? So you have to be very careful. And this is one that you'll often see on test questions, especially mock ones, because it's so easy to trip somebody up. They say, oh, otitis media, okay, 381.01, got it. Not paying attention to the details. And that's, like I keep saying, that'll get you on a test. Pay attention to the details. Don't go too fast. But do it in what? 1.5 minutes or something?
Yes.
This is where you want to bubble and highlight, right, Lorraine?
Yep. Although I tend to do that more in my CPT manual, but absolutely you can do it in your ICD manual. All right, so thank you. Good one.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.